Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel, and for today we're gonna be talking about a pest na tinatawag nating mealybugs, which is one of the most common pests that we could see sa ating mga succulents and ornamental plants in general. So since they are small, and if pagbadami na kayong mga succulents like what we have here, hindi na natin talaga maisa-isa yung ating mga succulents just to check on them. And if that happens, doon nga tayo nagkakaroon ng mealybug infestation sa ating mga gardens. And for today nga, I will be showing to you how do I get rid of mealybugs in our garden just in case we spot one. So ito yung ating Echeveria roma. So bago lang itong succulent na ito, and I noticed na may mga mealybugs nga siya sa kanyang mga leaves. So yung nakikita ninyong parang mga white thing dyan sa kanyang leaves are the actual mealybug. So they are soft and wax covered insects, and they are also known as piercing sucking insects. So ganun yung ginagawa nila sa ating mga succulents and other ornamental plants. And aside from that one, itong ating mga mealybugs na to also produces yung honeydew, kaya it really attracts yung ating mga ants. And in addition, itong honeydew na pinuproduce nila would eventually turn into yung black na sooty mold, a kind of fungus. So aside from pests, nagkaroon ka pa ng fungus, diba? Kaya it's very important to get rid of these mealybugs. So if you only have a small infestation naman, like for example isang succulent lang yung affected or plant, we can make use of this isopropyl or the rubbing alcohol. So ito yung typical na alcohol na ginagamit natin to disinfect our hands, and all you need to do is to spray it directly nga dito sa ating mga mealybugs and see what happens after spraying. Diba? Ayan, so parang na-destroy natin agad yung kanyang waxy covering, and eventually it would kill them. So ganito usually yung ginagawa ko pag may nakikita akong mealybugs na paisa-isa lang, ganyan. But in this case na sobrang dami ng parang mealybugs dito nga sa ating Echeveria roma, I have to spray it more often like that. Pero we have to remember na before we spray this isopropyl alcohol sa ating mga succulents or plants, we have to test it muna sa isang part ng kanyang leaves just to make sure na it won't burn the leaves. Yun yung tinatawag nating phytotoxicity, kasi syempre hindi lahat ng succulents or plants are the same. Some are actually sensitive to the alcohol, and we don't want to burn naman yung ating succulent leaf. So for this succulent, okay lang naman sa kanya yung alcohol upon testing, kaya we are now applying itong alcohol directly sa kanya. But then if we will be applying this, it would be very time consuming, and it won't really guarantee na lahat ng mealybugs including their eggs would die, especially doon sa pinakaloob na part. And so recently nga, what I usually do is to apply insecticide nga sa aking mga succulents. So we have this 7 and this chopper. So both of them, yung active ingredient nila is yung ating carbaryl. Ayan siya. Although recently kasi itong 7 mafi-phase out na siya, kaya we don't usually, or we won't usually see this soon. Kaya I have shifted na to chopper insecticide. So everything is actually the same, nagkaiba lang sa brand. And ang gamit naman nito is, kumbaga, ihahalo natin siya sa tubig, and yung liquid solution na yon is what we can use to spray sa ating mga succulents directly. Pwede natin siyang pangdilig, or like what I did before, sinoak ko talaga yung buong succulents or plants ko dito nga sa carbaryl solution na ito. So if you don't want naman yun, we also have yung mga granulated na insecticide. So sobrang daming choices ang pagpipilian sa market, but then yung active ingredient nila would be this carbofuran. Ayan, so this is one of the cheapest na kind ng insecticide that we have in the market. So all we need to do in applying this one is kumbaga ilagay lang natin siya sa pinakatop layer ng ating soil. We can actually also mix it sa ating potting mix. Ganyan, although we have to remember na harmful talaga, highly toxic itong ating mga carbofuran. Kaya if you have to use it, make sure na hindi siya maabot ng mga kids, ng mga animals or other pets natin. But if you are looking for an insecticide na medyo safe naman, they are not really that toxic to humans and mammals, you can make use of Starkel. Ayan, so both are Starkel, yung isa is from Japan and yung isa is from Thailand, and yung active ingredient niya naman is this dinotifuran. Ayan siya. So ang disadvantage lang nitong mga insecticides na to ay they are more expensive as compared to carbofuran, as in literally they are like 5 or 6 times more expensive than the carbofuran. So it's already, or it would already depend on your preference kung ano nga ba yung mas preferred ninyo. But recently I've been using itong mga Starkel Gina brand. So ayun lang guys, so if you wanted to save time talaga and make sure na lahat ng pests would die, even those na hindi natin nakikita, then go for systemic insecticide. Although pag in-apply natin yun, it won't be forever naman yung effect niya. So regularly, we have to use it about 2 to 3 months. So ganun yung interval ng application. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You may also visit our Facebook page, a Desert Succulent PH.